Now turn to part two. You will hear a photographer called Ian Gerard talking about his career. For questions 9 to 18, complete the sentences with a word or short phrase. You now have 45 seconds to look at part two.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Ian Gerard and I'm a photographer. I'm here to tell you a bit about my career so far and also about my new book. I often get asked if I studied photography at university, and people are sometimes surprised that I didn't. I wanted to, but my parents wouldn't let me, so I had to choose something else. I loved history, but my marks weren't very good, but I was keen on geography too. So that is what I did in the end. I actually think it's made me a better photographer and has given my work a broader context. On my degree course, in my final year, we studied all aspects of the development of cities and we had to do a presentation. We could do what we wanted and it was really interesting the topics people chose. I chose street markets for mine, but a friend did his on the growth of urban transport networks. On graduation, I went to the USA. I knew I wanted to work as a photographer, so I'd sent pictures to news organizations and advertising agencies, hoping I might get something in a brochure or even a newspaper. In fact, it was a magazine that noticed my pictures, and I worked for it for a year. I learnt a huge amount, but what I really wanted to do was see the USA for myself. I needed a theme, something really American, maybe photographing diners or shopping malls around the country. Then I remembered all those westerns I'd seen, and I just knew it had to be horses. I'd found what I wanted to focus on. It was an amazing 6 months. I started off in the baking heat of summer on the East Coast and finished my journey up in the mountains. I get the most striking shots in the winter light, although I do love the warmth in summer photos. Anyway, I came back to Britain at the beginning of spring and published my US photos in a small book. I earned just enough to finance my next trip round the UK. I felt it was time I explored my own country. I'd done a lot of driving in the USA and I wanted a change from the car, so went by motorbike instead. I love train travel, but I wanted to get to more remote areas. I wanted to explore the relationship between people and place. Interestingly, in the last few decades, many photographers from the UK haven't done much on fishing communities here, so that's what I did. They've tended to focus on family life in inner city communities instead. The resulting photos I'm putting together for my new book. One thing I've learnt is that it takes ages to produce a book, almost as long, in fact, as it took me to travel around Britain and then develop all the photos I'd taken. I started my journey in August and finished last month in November. My book won't be in the shops until March, though there's an exhibition of my pictures touring the UK from January. It's funny, I really wanted to call my book Visions, but apparently there's already one called that. So my publishers suggested the title In Focus, which I thought was horrible. In the end, we settled for Images, which is okay. Now I'm planning my next tour. I wasn't sure which theme to choose this time. I initially thought I'd look at lakes and mountains, but then I saw a tractor in a field, and I knew I'd do farming. I've decided to use a special camera to create very large photos, which I'm hoping to exhibit next year. Well, if you have any questions about my new...
Now you'll hear part two again.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Ian Gerard, and I'm a photographer. I'm here to tell you a bit about my career so far, and also about my new book. I often get asked if I studied photography at university, and people are sometimes surprised that I didn't. I wanted to, but my parents wouldn't let me, so I had to choose something else. I loved history, but my marks weren't very good, but I was keen on geography too, so that is what I did in the end. I actually think it's made me a better photographer and has given my work a broader context. On my degree course, in my final year, we studied all aspects of the development of cities and we had to do a presentation. We could do what we wanted and it was really interesting the topics people chose. I chose street markets for mine, but a friend did his on the growth of urban transport networks. On graduation, I went to the USA. I knew I wanted to work as a photographer, so I'd sent pictures to news organisations and advertising agencies, hoping I might get something in a brochure or even a newspaper. In fact, it was a magazine that noticed my pictures, and I worked for it for a year. I learnt a huge amount, but what I really wanted to do was see the USA for myself. I needed a theme, something really American. Maybe photographing diners or shopping malls around the country. Then I remembered all those westerns I'd seen, and I just knew it had to be horses. I'd found what I wanted to focus on. It was an amazing 6 months. I started off in the baking heat of summer on the East Coast and finished my journey up in the mountains. I get the most striking shots in the winter light, although I do love the warmth in summer photos. Anyway, I came back to Britain at the beginning of spring and published my US photos in a small book. I earned just enough to finance my next trip round the UK. I felt it was time I explored my own country. I'd done a lot of driving in the USA and I wanted a change from the car, so went by motorbike instead. I love train travel, but I wanted to get to more remote areas. I wanted to explore the relationship between people and place. Interestingly, in the last few decades, many photographers from the UK haven't done much on fishing communities here, so that's what I did. They've tended to focus on family life in inner city communities instead. The resulting photos I'm putting together for my new book. One thing I've learnt is that it takes ages to produce a book. Almost as long, in fact, as it took me to travel around Britain and then develop all the photos I'd taken. I started my journey in August and finished last month in November. My book won't be in the shops until March, though there's an exhibition of my pictures touring the UK from January. It's funny, I really wanted to call my book Visions, but apparently there's already one called that. So my publishers suggested the title In Focus, which I thought was horrible. In the end, we settled for Images, which is okay. Now I'm planning my next tour. I wasn't sure which theme to choose this time. I initially thought I'd look at lakes and mountains, but then I saw a tractor in a field and I knew I'd do farming. I've decided to use a special camera to create very large photos, which I'm hoping to exhibit next year. Well, if you have any questions about my new...
That is the end of part two.